For today. Please put your hands together for Mr. Esmeralda, our very hard-working principal.
We thank you for being here today for this auspicious occasion. Representing Governor Abercrombie's office, Candy Everett. The chairperson for the Hawaii State Foundation Culture of the Arts, Ms. Barbara Saramines-Gan. The most special guest here today, Mr. Kazu Kauinana. Project manager here from the Foundation of Cultural Arts, Mr. John Johnson. Under the direction of Kuhio Kanekoa, members of Palau Kalo Kalaloa.
There's one mele, Hawaiian mele, that I know that was written for the O'OPU, and it's called O'OPU Nui Teve Teve. And to honor the mana'o of this symbol as a male symbol, our kane, our men, would like to dance this for you today.
And in the old days, long time ago, when I was a kid, I used to go to the beach and sit on the rocks and watch the O'OPU skip from pond to pond. Historically, Kapolei has been in an upward climb, as the O'OPU does in its move from the ocean to the streams, up until the ponds and the mountainside, because the O'OPU truly is a symbol of what this community and these students are all about. Mahalo.
Please welcome Ms. Barbara Saramines-Gan.
Very pleased with the way that everyone was involved in the project. So I think it's really fantastic. We've got this morning the artist who created these works for the school and for the students and the community of Kapolei. So now please join me in welcoming the artist Kazu Kauinana.
I would like to thank Kapolei High School and the Malama Learning Center for allowing me to build this creation on the campus. Brandon Wagner for his mud gun skills and interesting adventure stories. Micah Mela Silva for being a dedicated worker, for his appreciation of paramilitary fashion, and for sharing the project with his friends and other artists. Grant Pohina Hernandez for his garden hose skills, humor, and inspirational toughness. Ikaika Ohia, a KCC student who volunteered during the clay modeling process and who acted as my Hawaiian language translator. I would also like to recognize Joel Gray. Joel was crucial in the installation of the concrete pieces. And finally, to the student body of Kapolei High School, I hope you accept the sculpture as a gift. It was created with your dreams of success in mind. Being unique, adaptable, changing to meet your goals will be necessary as you learn and grow. Don't be afraid, go for it. The idea to use the O'OPU H'I'U KOLE for this project was reinforced when I was on a voyage to the Northwest Hawaiian Islands with NOAA's Teacher at Sea program. After seeing the pristine environments of the Northwest Hawaiian Islands, I felt that I had made the right decision to choose this endemic animal with complex and unique characteristics. The O'OPU H'I'U KOLE is unique, evolved, adaptable, and tenacious. These are the same qualities we hope will inspire students. The O'OPU hatchlings are swept from mountaintop pools to the ocean shore. They live in salt water until they are strong enough to make a difficult climb along streams and waterfalls back to their freshwater mountain habitat. The O'OPU on campus are making their way to the library, the symbol of knowledge and the pinnacle of their journey. The biggest part of a work of art is the imagination. Mahalo.
Mahalo nui ma ko I oi. No ke iho oi e ke la ka mahao e olu oru ke. E pu mai kai mai oi. No ke iha o hana ana oru. I rohi I ko ma ko puni. Heavenly God, we thank you for allowing us to gather today. Keep all those that are here. Let them return home safely. And enjoy this wonderful day.
Kazu has two other magnificent sculpture projects, one at Moiliili Elementary School and one at Campbell High School. You should really go out and try to find them.